Hi, I'm Peter Boie, and I'm going to show you how to turn your ordinary dog into Krypto the Superdog. I have to say, I'm very excited about the new Superman movie coming out, and I'm even more excited because Krypto the Superdog is making his first appearance in a major motion picture, and it got me thinking, I have a cute little white dog named Tucker, and he's super, but how could I make him even more super? And that's when I started brainstorming ideas how to turn an ordinary dog into Krypto the Superdog. And this is what I came up with. If you make this and try it out on your dog, make sure you take some pictures and tag me in the post. All right, let's get into the build.
The first thing I did was to Google Krypto the Superdog because, to be honest, I didn't know much about Krypto, and I found some great images of Krypto from a cartoon. This one has a traditional Superman logo as his dog tag and also a gold or yellow collar with a red cape. Then I found a great screen grab of Krypto from the movie, and you can see his collar here has little blue nubs around it. His dog tag is an all gold Superman logo. I liked the traditional logo from the cartoon, so I combined the two. I used the collar from the movie and the traditional Superman logo from the cartoon. I googled Superman logos to model my dog tag after. I found a bunch of great options. I went with the one without the black logo around it because I didn't want black in my final print. I downloaded the Superman logo as a PNG and then went to a great website called convertio.co and was able to convert that PNG file to an SVG file, which my 3D CAD software Fusion will need. I downloaded my SVG file and then went to a new project in Fusion, clicked on insert, went down to insert SVG, found the file, and inserted it into my project. I repositioned it, and as you can see, after you position it and insert it into the sketch, the lines become active lines that you can actually extrude from. Then I extruded the Superman logo from the SVG file and put a little loop at the top for the keyring. Then I designed the collar cape holder. This was my first design and it was way too long, and so I designed a shorter one with a deeper chamber in it. Then I made a collar extender to make it look like the gold collar was going farther around the dog's neck. Time to print out the dog tag. I think it came out pretty super if you ask me. I printed this at 80% of its original size, so if you have a smaller dog, you can print it smaller. If you have a larger dog, you can print it at its original size. It's time to make the cape. The cape needs to be made out of a thin material. I went with these juggling scarves I found on Amazon, so when you roll them up, they'll fit into the chamber. You need to cut the juggling scarf to make it look like a cape, so make little cuts the length of the chamber and add on an inch to account for the hem. Then use those slits and cut at an angle up 10 inches like this. Then you have to make sure that the scarf doesn't fray and fall apart on you while it's being used, so we're going to use some hem adhesive, otherwise known as stitch witchery, to make a hem on this very thin juggling scarf. Make sure you iron on a towel or an ironing board so you don't burn or melt your tabletop. Then grab a piece of scrap fabric that you don't care about. This is going to protect your iron from getting adhesive on it. Peel off the backing to your fabric and then fold it over onto itself like this. Fold over your scrap piece of fabric over the hem to protect your iron from the adhesive, and then iron the adhesive so it melts and creates your hem. You will probably get some of the adhesive on your scrap fabric, so don't let it cool all the way. Make sure you peel away your scrap fabric before it cools completely and is harder to peel away. And do that for the entire length of your hem. Don't forget to do the other side. And then your Krypto Super Cape is ready. Then it's time to print out the collar extenders. These go on your dog's collar to make it look like the gold collar is going farther around their neck. Then I printed out the sliding cover to the chamber. Then I printed out the cape chamber. I had bed adhesion issues on the left side of this print. This caused the left side of my print to come up off the bed and create a slightly warped left side of my print, which caused the sliding cover not to slide smoothly and not be flush with the bottom. This yellow filament is Sunlu filament I got off of Amazon, so it's not bamboo filament. I don't think I have this problem with bamboo filament, but I haven't run a test on that yet. After digging online, I found a solution. The solution is to turn off the auxiliary fan because the fan is cooling the first few layers too much, causing it not to stick to the print bed. Here's how to turn off the auxiliary fan. Click on the settings drop-down menu for the filament you want to turn it off for and click on Edit. Then click on the Cooling tab and scroll all the way to the bottom to the auxiliary cooling fan setting and put that at 0%. This is a filament by filament setting, so you need to turn this off for every filament that you want the auxiliary fan off for. After turning off the auxiliary fan, I had zero bed adhesion issues. Just for comparison, check out how off these two prints were from each other. And the cover slides so smoothly on the perfect print. I think all the prints came out very nice. I just used a little gaffer's tape to attach the cape to the inside of the collar chamber. Then you have to fold and roll the cape to fit inside the collar chamber like this. Then slide the collar cover onto the collar chamber. Then thread your dog's collar through the collar loops on the back and tape them into place, otherwise it'll slide all around the collar. And do the same with the two collar extenders on each side of the collar chamber. Attach your Superman logo dog tag and you're ready to test it out on your pup. This is my dog, we call him Tucker. He's Tuckerman_the_dog on Instagram if you want to follow him there. Make sure you have plenty of tasty treats for your dog to do this with them. I will say he wasn't very excited to put the collar on, so I had him eat some treats off of it to try to get him used to it. Eventually, Tucker let me put the collar on him. Then it was time for a photo shoot. When you're ready to turn your dog into a super dog, just slide open the cover, pull out the cape, and he goes from ordinary dog to super dog. And there he is, from ordinary Tucker to Tucker the Superdog. Here's a quick comparison from Tucker the Superdog and Krypto the Superdog. Not too shabby. Tucker didn't even mind the fan that was blowing his fur and cape in the wind. It's a bird. It's a plane. No, wait. That's Tucker the Superdog to the rescue. Luckily, Tucker the Superdog landed at my house. Chipmunks have infiltrated our backyard and are digging a network of tunnels. Please save us, Tucker the Superdog. Thank you, Tucker the Superdog, for saving us from chipmunks.
I hope you like this project. If you make one up for your dog, be sure to take pictures and videos and tag me in your posts. I would love to see what your dog looks like as Krypto the Superdog. Be sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next project.